You've seen her comedy concerts in all the big cities, like Zorro, Ohio at the Elks Lodge, at Bingo Halls in Stockholm, Wisconsin, and working the retirement home in Louisiana, Missouri. And now you hear her thoughts on her No Reason podcast. Here's Nola J, the chocolate blonde, on the No Reason podcast.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Welcome to the No Reason podcast. I'm your host, Nola J, aka Chocolate Blonde, aka Jizzle. I hope everyone had a great couple of weeks. I've been gone for a few weeks. We had Labor Day, we had the holiday, we had the end of the summer. A lot was going on. I'm back. And I think I'm going to call this season two. This is the 31st episode. So I'm going to go ahead and make this season two because I do what I want. It's my podcast. And as a call for no reason. No reason. For no reason, this is season two. And starting off with season two, episode 31, I decided I'm bringing on a co-host. So it's time for a co-host this season. We'll see how long he lasts. But I do have a co-host. So I'm going to let him go ahead and introduce himself. So go ahead, co-host. Introduce yourself. Co-host. I always say co-ho.
Hey, you watch the mouth. Anyway, my name is Don Suave. I'm actually the long-lost brother of Nola J, a.k.a. Jizzle. And I don't want to talk too much about myself, but I'm an artist, just like Nola, but not a stand-up comedian, but I do music. I produce, I sing, and songwriting, stuff like that. So we'll get into that at some point. But that's a little bit about me. I also do marketing on the side. If you've ever seen Nola J's website, nolajcomedy.com, that was developed by my company. We manage that. All of her show dates, her podcast, you can go check out all that on her website. Plug, 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 plug.
Do a great job at my website. The only issue is I forget to give you dates. And that's because I'm apparently in the Comedian Witness Protection Program, where I'm not allowed to share my shows. I don't know what my issue is with that, but I'll get with that. I do have a reason in the past why I wouldn't do that, why I wouldn't give all my dates on my website. But I promise, coming up, I'm going to start doing better and put my dates up. But otherwise, you do a great job on a website. So you do that for anyone who would like to do that, right?
Yeah, anybody. I mean, honestly, I like working with artists, but any business, any small business that needs leads, needs customers, needs fans, I can help you turn up in that aspect.
And so how could they contact you? And I'll put this in the description of the podcast as well. Like if you want services.
If you want to hit me personally, you can hit me on my Instagram at I am Don Suave. It's all one word. My Twitter is the same way. You can hit me there personally. If you want to learn more about my marketing company, that's alavon365.com, alavon365.com. We work with small businesses, restaurants. I've got a guy that does hair for celebrities out in Hollywood, like those extensions and stuff.
You call them extensions.
I mean, okay. Lace front, lace, all that stuff.
I don't know. I don't wear any of that either. So look, I don't know the right word either, but right, extensions, weave, whatever.
Yeah, but we got
that's what he do.
I don't know if I'm not going to name drop him, but he does hair for everybody from Cardi B. He was just on tour with Ariana Grande for like 3 months, but we set him up an e-commerce store, and he's made a lot of money. He was just living in Mississippi.
Okay. Yeah, I was about to say, don't tell that man business like that. Hold on.
He doesn't mind, but I'm not going to put him out there. But if you
I know, but you was about to really get into it.
Yeah, but if you reach out to me directly, I can I can, if anybody's interested, I can talk to you about what we can do and what we've done and all that. But
okay, cool. I'll put that in the description of the podcast. And then if you become, you know, a permanent co-host.
Yeah, right.
You're on probation right now. I'll have my peoples added on to the voiceovers in the beginning and the after the podcast. I'll have my guy do that if I keep you on. But anywho,
but that's
listen to me.
No, and then I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't shout out an app that me and a partner are developing. It's a food truck app. It's not the first ever, but it's one of the only ordering.
Oh, really? Because I really, really love, I like food trucks. I mess with food trucks. So if you're saying that is like where you can order ahead, that's perfect. That's real perfect. I have a lot that I really like to go to. So that's cool. That's good to hear. You're doing a lot of things. We are having technical difficulties, so we're going to take a break for the sponsor, and then we'll be right back for the No Reason Podcast. When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions, like how do I record an episode, how to get my show into all the apps people like to listen to, how do I make money from this podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is really simple. Anchor. Anchor is the one-stop shop for recording, hosting your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free, and it's ridiculously easy to use. Even my chocolate blonde self can use it. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid to podcast right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad. I love it. It's simple. You know, I'm an airhead, so I just put things together, has all the tools you need. I can distribute this to all kind of platforms. I'm on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, wherever you listen to your podcast, you can have your podcast there. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. I can't wait to hear your podcast. I am curious about this app now. Now, tell me more about Calling Ahead or whatever else this app does, because I love food trucks.
So the issue is calling ahead to a food truck is like a pain because there's only a couple of them on the truck, so you can't really answer the phones with people in line and people, and you know, you got to actually cook the food. So right. We built an app that's connected to a printer that sits on their food truck that doesn't need any wireless connection or anything. It just works like a cell phone. And then you or me goes into the app, orders food, sends it, we pay for it right in the app, and then it sends it straight to their cook right inside the food truck through the printer.
Wow, that's dope.
And then you get their exact location in your phone after you ordered it. You could walk up, pick it up, show them your order number, boom, walk away. You don't have to wait in line. And you don't have to spend your whole lunch break waiting in line at a food.
So you mean to tell me if there's a particular truck I like, no matter where it's at, I can send in my order and then it'll let me know where that truck is at and I can go get my food.
No matter where it's at. We've also built it in so when they park somewhere, they press a button and it announces their location to Twitter and Facebook. So you
Are you done with this app? Or because I hope you ain't telling something. I know you're smart enough not to be telling an idea that has not already been taken care of. I mean, I'm just saying. I just thought, sorry, the big sister role came in all of a sudden. Like, hey, man. So, hey, this is a good idea. Be quiet. But I'm pretty sure you didn't already.
Yeah, it was
pretty much in the works.
It was an idea 2 years ago. We launched in D.C. We had one of the most popular food trucks in DC signed up already. He actually just went viral because of the whole chicken sandwich thing. And he had a tweet that went viral because of that, because his chicken sandwiches are better. But yeah, there's other food. There's like a food truck there's like an app in every city that lets you find food trucks. But ours is like unique because we allow you to order ahead. And the printer is the thing that's our real differentiator, because we have a wireless printer that sits in the truck. Because people that drive food trucks don't want to be answering the phone. They don't want to be texting that an order came in. They don't need another iPad to mess around with. They like having that printer just print the ticket. Boom.
Somebody's that's a very good idea. That's a good idea. So what's the name of that truck in D.C.? Look, I love food trucks. What's the name of that one in D.C.?
Okay, I'm going to shout out somebody else. It's Roman Rooster. Roman Rooster. They
just,
you just come by BET. They had a BET.
Cool. Okay. Well, we'll put all your information in the, in the description, so we can get you a little plug and get you some more business going. Because you do develop apps, right? That's another thing you do, I thought.
Yeah. But, if anybody needs help with marketing just in general, they can just contact me or hit.
Hello, that's me. Even though I part of it is my fault. But, I'll be using more of your services besides my website. And we can segue into this. I was talking a couple of weeks ago of some exciting things I had in work. Here's another one. I guess I can speak on it now. I'm going to start doing a once-a-month comedy show.
Mm.
Called the No Reason Live, and I decided to do here locally in Milwaukee because I was getting tired of people always saying, you're never here, you're always out of town, blah, blah, blah. So starting in October, that's my new venture, is to do a show like once a month. I think I can afford to be home once a month and do a show, and I'm going to use Don Suave's services is marketing this comedy show. So we'll see how this goes. Let's see if you're good as you say you are.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Actions speak louder than words.
Oh, that's my saying. That is I live by that. So we'll see what you do. But I'm excited about that because then I could bring in some of my good friends that are, that are on TV and I'm not. Hey, at least I was on Showtime one time. But I'm just saying, so I can bring in a lot of good comics come in. And I'm excited about that. And then the other stuff that's coming up, I'll talk about it when it actually happens. I don't like to talk about stuff that's not there, if you know what I mean.
I know what you mean. And that is exciting. For sure.
Hey, you came up with the No Reason Live. I'll give you credit.
Yeah, you had some I don't know what name you had, but
I was just saying No Reason comedy show or something like that. Like I was throwing comedy in it.
1940s.
Whatever, dude. It wasn't no 1940s, you jerk. Okay. let's get into these let's get into the news. Let's talk about some stuff. On this I like to always start with the sports. And now that I have a Redskins fan on the damn line with me, I'm gonna start with my Packers, and you could talk about your Redskins. Exciting NFL season opener was the Packers and the Bears, and of course the Bears suck, and we beat them. I'll be honest with you, that game was a little rough to watch because our offense sucked, and the Bears defense was killing. And we squeaked through it, so I'm glad we made it through. I think it was like 10-3 at the end of the day. I can't remember.
Isn't that always how it is with the Bears and the Packers?
I mean, it's a big rivalry. Division. Like we really hate each other. Like honestly, I'm under Jay Hood's podcast family, and he's from Chicago, and he does ESPN Chicago, and. Normally I come on the show when the Packers play the Bears and we go at it, make fun. He still owe me for a bet because we always win. But it's a big rivalry and it is kind of like that. But they defense, I'm not giving them any credit. I'm not going to even say it. I'm just going to say that game we see what we're working with. And Rodgers, I'm a little upset he still has a girlfriend. Packer fans don't like when he's in a relationship. We can't stand abroad. We don't like her. She's that car racing chick, Danica or whatever. She's going to have to go. I can't hear you. What did you say?
I said Danica Patrick, her?
Yeah, that's Rogers. That's Rogers. You got to get on a mic, sir. You can't be falling off the mic like that. I'm going to have to teach you mic etiquette. You're a singer.
Pause. But yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you a singer and all that. You know what's up with the mic. You can't be doing all that, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So we won. I was happy about that. I don't know if anyone heard the hot mic. I thought I heard something, but apparently it did hear something. One of the players has said, I've never had my butt fingered.
Hold on, what?
I thought I heard something crazy, but maybe it was, I don't know. But NBA picked up a hot mic. I'll read the article. The Green Bay Packers 10-3 Thursday over the host Chicago Bears was called boring by sports. Okay, wait. Sorry, I lost my train of thought. Okay. But at least the conversation was lively. A hot mic on the NBC broadcast captured someone saying, I've never had my butt finger. The Big Lead and Deadspin reported it was a Packers or a Bears player who made the declaration.
No shit.
But we won't point fingers here. The Packers led the Bears at that time 7-3. The second quarter at that time. Okay, I've never had my butt fingered. Okay, that's the Packers news. Oh, another thing with the Packers, we have our safety, Darnell Savage. He changed his number to 21 so he could become 21 Savage. I thought that was dope.
Yes, you did.
I did. So with your Redskins, you want to talk about your Redskins?
Nah, I don't think anything.
Oh, you want to talk about watching the Redskins? You want to talk about that one?
First quarter was looking good. You were looking like
real good.
The Redskin killer, Deshaun Jackson, just showed out. So, you know. But that's what we're used to. You know, we're used to looking good in the beginning, you know, showing some promise. And then reality hits and, you know. It is what it is.
I guess so, man. I don't know. I remember because I used to hang out in the DMV all the time. Redskins. I went to a couple games, to be honest. Yeah, it was a good time. That was back when – I don't even remember. I'm not going to even start lying. But Sunday, because the Packers weren't playing, I did Red Zone, which I like to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I was able to catch a lot of good action. It was some good football games. Miami – Miami players started reaching out to their agents after the first quarter trying to get traded. That was funny. Baltimore was balling. What happened? Like,
yeah, that was the biggest surprise.
And then, Hollywood Brown, like that. I like his name now. I don't know what it is. He showed out. There was three of them that showed out for Baltimore. The quarterback, what's the quarterback's name?
Lamar Jackson, I believe.
I think so. Don't get it. Yep. No, we're not official sportscasters, so people don't judge us if we get the names and stuff wrong.
This is the name, Lamar Jackson. He showed potential the last couple of years, but that game. But see, the thing with the NFL is you could look unstoppable one week.
Right.
But then when they start the game plan against you, you could become average. So we'll see.
We'll see how it go, but I just thought it was funny how the Miami Dolphins were already contacting the agents. Like, we went out. Like, it's the first game. That's it. All right, let me do a little bit about my Milwaukee Bucks because you know I always got to do my local shit. The Brewers, we just played the Cubs. We played the Cubs and the Bears at the same time. I mean, not, you know, baseball. You know, there's more games. And we beat the Cubs. I think we beat the Cubs in that series. They might have won one game. I hate the fact that I can't look this stuff up right now. But, yeah. So, yeah, the Brewers is doing their thing. The Bucks, we're getting ready. I tried to watch that game Saturday. I got up early Saturday morning and tried to watch Greece versus USA because Giannis was, you know, Giannis is on the Greece team.
Mm-hmm.
So I go to put on ESPN because I stream everything. I don't pay for cable anymore. And damn it, ESPN got a new damn channel called ESPN Plus. So I could get all the games. Yeah, now it's called ESPN Plus. And I go to hit the game. I'm all excited. I'm like, yeah, I'm about to see this. Next thing you know, it's like $5.99 if you want to stream. What? How am I able to watch all of ESPN? Now y'all got another show, another channel within ESPN that's charging. I was done. I just went on Twitter and followed that way. And then once I got on Twitter, that was a problem. Because then I got into the Antonio Brown saga.
Yeah.
That took over my whole Saturday morning. But before I get into that, for the Milwaukee Bucks, really quick, we're coming back, of course. Season's coming back. I'm excited. But Sterling Brown had a lawsuit against our Milwaukee police, and they settled for $400,000 for him. He was going to give him $400,000. Sterling Brown refuses to take that until they acknowledge what they did, and I think the racial part about it and all that. So I don't know if they ever resolved that yet. I haven't heard anything. But, yeah, they offer him $400,000, which is really rare in Wisconsin, especially Milwaukee, for the police to actually pay and say he was in the wrong. I'm shocked.
But it was a settlement, so it technically they didn't say they were in the wrong.
But he wants them to because he's not going to take the money. He's not going to settle for that. Put it that way, he's not going to accept it. I think it was an offer. They offered, and he's not going to take that offer. He wants them to come out and apologize publicly and admit what they did wrong.
Mm.
He's like, yeah. And you have to understand, after this incident happened, because our new owners are from the East Coast, they even said it. They have never experienced the racism and the racial stuff that go on. They white men that go on here. It's shocking.
It is shocking. It doesn't take long for you to be like, whoa, this place is different.
Right, but Sterling Brown knows about it because he's from Chicago. So he's like, yeah. All right, let's move on. Now I told you I got consumed with Antonio Brown Saturday morning. That was the most entertaining thing. Now, my second football team is the Steelers. I didn't want to talk about them earlier because Sunday night game pissed me off. That was a joke. Because I lived in Pittsburgh for a while, so that's my second team. So I'm very familiar with Antonio Brown. But all that shit that went down on Saturday was hilarious. Did you keep up with that on Saturday?
I actually did. I heard about him getting cut. That's when I first started following it. I didn't hear about the video, the Nike commercial he made until you posted it. And then him telling, I didn't know he told the Raiders to cut him because I guess his contract didn't have guaranteed money or something like that.
No, this is what happened. Dude was skipping practices because he went into one of those crypto tanks, one of those tanks that you freeze yourself.
You're talking about crowd therapy?
Yeah, and his feet got messed up in it. Oh. His feet got messed up. So that was the first issue. Then I think he started missing practices or coming up late or something. And then the last straw was he got into it with the coach. And they claim he called the coach a cracker. So
I think it was a GM or something.
The GM or someone he called him a cracker. And so they fined him. once they fined him, he lost his guarantees because the fine was like $200,000. So he lost.
Okay.
So then his mind was like, why should I play? Like, I didn't lost my guarantee because he had a guarantee amount of money.
Mm-hmm.
And so then after that, he got fined. Then he taped the conversation of him talking to the coach, and that's when he made it into a damn Nike commercial.
Which I heard he got permission.
He did, but you know news. I ain't gonna lie. As much as I hate to disagree with number 45, as much as I hate to agree with number 45, he is kind of right. It do be fake news. It just be clickbait. People just want to get something out there so you can click on it.
Yep.
But he did get approved. But the way he put it together, it looked like a damn Nike commercial.
It was sick. He's got a video guy. I mean,
then
he knows what he's doing. You know, it's crazy.
And then after that had happened, I told you I got all involved. Then after that point, I'm on Twitter like, I'm stuck. Like, this is getting... And then Mike Tomlin started trending, which I love Mike Tomlin. He's so sexy. Anyways, sorry. So he started trending because they were like, well, maybe Tomlin did know something we didn't know because he had to deal with him for about 8 years, I think. And if Antonio is acting the way he's acting right now with the Raiders in these few months, then they figure Tomlin was dealing with a head case in the locker room. And so now they're like, this man is a saint because everybody was talking about he had no control over his team. Because he had Yvonne Ball and Antonio Brown.
Yeah.
And Ben, Big Ben, who's been accused for sexual assault and pass. He had some issues on his team.
Sure did.
Right. So that was trendy. And then finally, Antonio asked to be released. They released him. Then he signed with the Patriots. And then there was a video with him being happy about it, which looked like another Nike video. And then he come to find out he had a social media team he was working with the whole entire time.
Yeah.
He said he asked social media experts how to get his Raiders release. So I guess that's what they came up with all that.
This is the age we live in. You know, you got to, if you ain't getting attention, you ain't getting money. And he's definitely, that's an example of you create news to get into people's minds. And whew, that's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, everyone's all like, he's a head case, he's this and that. But at the end of the day, he went where he wanted to go. He wanted to be with Tom Brady.
Yeah, Brady's like, hey.
Tom was like, come on, I had Randy. And then Randy Moss started trending after this happened. This is what I'm saying, dude. I was on Twitter all morning getting all, I was all in it. Randy Moss, you remember Brady took under Randy Moss.
Yep.
So then Randy Moss started trending. I'm like, okay, what is Randy talking about? Then I got into that loop, and it was just funny. It was very entertaining. I had a good time. There was some funny shit. Twitter is hilarious. I had some good stuff on Twitter cracking up. But today, something hit that Antonio Brown now is being sued by a woman who claims the New England Patriots star sexually assaulted and raped her during three separate encounters. Three? Okay. This according to a new lawsuit that happened to come out. Now I'm adding extra shit. Let me be quiet. Let me finish this. The woman behind the lawsuit, who identifies herself as Brittany Taylor, Brittany, says she was hired by Brown as a personal trainer. Taylor claims the first incident happened in June 2017 during a training session when Brown exposed himself and kissed her without her consent. Taylor then described a second alleged incident later that month. Brown, while positioned behind her, began masturbating near her without her knowledge and ejaculating on her back. Okay, I'm just going to stop for a second. No, I'm just going to stop for 1 minute because I'm a woman and there are true Me Too sexual rape. That stuff really goes down, and I'm not knocking anyone or say anyone's liars or anything like that. But me, I'm going to talk about me personally. If you did that shit the first time, I was uncomfortable. I'm not seeing you the second damn time. I'm just not. If you expose yourself and I didn't feel no type of way like I wanted to get with you and you kissed me and I felt disgusted, I'm not going to see you the second time. I'm not.
Especially right after. Right.
I'm not going to do it. Right. It was later that month. I'm not going to. I'm not. Because technically, you didn't. It wasn't like you grabbed me or forced me and did that. That's a different story.
But how do you get positioned in a way that you ejaculate on someone's back? Like, how? What position is this? Is she? What is she doing? Is she in the garden? Is she?
Well,
how does that work?
Well, young man, let me listen before you get yourself in. Look, before you get yourself in trouble with women, let me say this because you go. I don't want you to get in trouble.
I'm asking you because
So later on, while positioned behind her, so she's doing personal training. So I guess she was showing him how to do squats. I don't know. And he just started masturbating. And then he ejaculated on... that's gangster. I'm sorry. Then he ejaculated on her back. Okay, that was later on that month. So then Taylor claims the first incident occurred at Brown's home in Pittsburgh. And the second incident occurred at Brown's home in Florida. So why do you keep going to his house? Okay. If it happened the first time, it'd be like, yo, meet me at a gym, yo. Meet me. I wouldn't do it the second time. Because apparently, I wouldn't have done it the second time. I would have been like, dude, I'm good. You're going to have to get you a new personal trainer. Unless she paid. I don't know. Maybe it's about the money. I don't know. This story confuses me. So it happened in Pittsburgh one time, then it happened in Florida the second time, my good old state of Florida. Now, according to the lawsuit filed in the federal court in Florida, Taylor claims Brown bragged about the incident to her in a profane and angry text message. Why does she keep in contact with him? Like, the only reason I say this is because it's not like he's her boss or he's someone where, like, she can just stop
right
messing with him. Like, you don't, okay, I get it, you're afraid to report stuff, you don't want to say anything, he's a football player, maybe whatever, okay, I get all that, maybe you want to not do all that, but you, that doesn't mean like he is he blackmailing you to, bitch, you better come back to my house so I can assault you again, because I'm gonna do what? Like, that's the part I don't understand. Like, why'd you go again? I don't get it. So three times. Hold on. So then she claims several months later, Brown reached out to her and begged for forgiveness. Taylor claims Brown begged her to continue training him. Like, she must be the best trainer in the world.
I mean, it sounds like it.
Or she thinks she's the best trainer in the world. And after her initial hesitation, she ultimately agreed. See, this, listen, man, three times? Okay, hold on.
That's why I laugh because I know the ending to this. I know the, because this okay. is just.
So, however, the woman claims nearly a year later, on May 20th, 2018, Brown cornered her, forced her down onto a bed, pushed her face into the mattress, and forcibly raped her. The woman claims she tried to fight back, but Brown was too strong and physically outpowered her. In the suit, the woman claims she screamed and cried throughout the entire incident, repeating, shouting, no, and stop. Brown refused to stop and penetrated her. In her suit, Taylor describes herself as a 28-year-old world-class gymnast who competed at elite levels of international competition. In her suit, Taylor claims she met Antonio Brown while they were student athletes at Central Michigan University, where they participated in a fellowship of Christian athlete group. So she knew him way before this. In her suit, Taylor says she wants compensation. Of course you do. She wants compensation for physical injuries, pain, and suffering, embarrassment, stress, and anxiety, and loss of self-esteem. Okay. There's a couple things that I don't understand about this. How come she ain't trying to press charges? Is there's no statutory limitation on rape? I don't know. We're not experts. I don't know what the statutory limitation is on sexual assault or rape.
Like 40 years later, 30 years later.
So. I mean, Bill Cosby in jail, R. Kelly about to go. So how come she ain't getting criminal charges?
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand. Second of all, Antonio Brown responded, his lawyer, and said that these allegations are false and that she's just mad because he wouldn't invest in one of her businesses for $1.6 million. And I think it's ironic, like, and Antonio Brown didn't say this, but he denies all that. And he said they had a consensual sexual relationship. To me, that's what it sounds like. Like, exactly what he's saying. Like, they messed around, they had sex, they had some type of little relationship. She asked for some money. He said no. And another thing that Antonio Brown says, she posts a lot of pictures of him with her on her social media just to get that clout, period. And now all of a sudden he's big news this whole weekend, and now this pops up.
Signs the one big one-year deal with the Patriots, and now he's a target.
So we'll stay tuned, and we'll keep our eye on this story to see how it pans out. Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy. I get the Me Too thing and all that. And like I said, I'm not knocking that if that's the case. I'm just saying this shit is getting out of hand. It's just getting out of hand. Like, let's use our common sense, people, and let's wait till we get all the facts before people start judging and assuming. Because you know this is making headlines right now. You realize this. This is making headlines as we speak. Antonio Brown accused of rape 3 times. The part I don't understand is why there's no criminal charges. That's the part I don't get. Especially in this climate that we live in right now, they'll dig all the way back to when you was 5 and be like, you remember that candy bar you stole from the store? Well, we're going to hold that against you now. So I'm just shocked that we are having technical difficulties. Be back in 1 sec. He was never charged criminally. Like, I don't know how this stuff works. I don't know, you do a lawsuit first and then you press charges. I don't know how any of this shit works. It's ass backwards to me that she trying to get compensation first and she ain't said nothing about trying to press charges for the rape. This shit is all shady. It makes no sense to me. I might be reading it wrong. Once again, we just reading what the news put out there anyway, right? So who knows?
Who knows how that goes? I'm trying to figure out that second one, though.
How he was able to...
She turned around for 2 seconds to do a move, and he all of a sudden automatically ejaculated on her back. I'm trying to figure that out. That was
cool. I don't mean to laugh, but first of all, she was at his house in Florida
right
when that happened. She's supposed to be doing personal training. So I don't know if she was showing him squats or she was whatever, but he was able to nut on her back.
He must have been a move for him to bust that quick. That's all I'm saying.
Listen, the whole shit don't make any damn sense. Okay?
But
shit don't make any sense.
If it's my house, I should be able to nut. Okay. But yeah, anyway, I'm just trying to figure it out. Whatever I want.
It's my house.
It's my house. You don't want to get nut on, go outside.
It's my house. I nut on your back. You shouldn't have came here. What's wrong with you?
That's all I'm saying.
You know how I get down. You know what happened the last time you came to my house?
Ain't no secret.
So why are you surprised? Now I'm going to nut on your back.
And then next?
Right.
I don't.
Yeah, don't take it that far. You calm down.
I'm just, you know, don't know.
But there's one other, thing I'm going to say about this Antonio Brown that had me crack it up was O.J. Simpson. His crazy ass had the audacity. This is his exact words. O.J. Simpson said, "Hey, Antonio Brown, you are killing my fantasy team."
Hey, he's. I need to follow him. I need to put him up there with.
No, you don't. He's ignorant.
Just so I can listen to his tweets.
He's an ignorant asshole.
It's not like he's going to jump in to every event and tweet something. That just
the reason he got on Twitter is because of fantasy football, and so he can do his fantasy football and talk shit. That's the only reason he got on Twitter.
Okay.
But he's an asshole. Because he's entitled. Fool, you killed like two damn people. Do you get it?
Well, yeah.
I can't believe he said, "Antonio Brown, you are murdering, you are killing my fantasy team." Like, dude, you should never use murder, killing, knife, blood, white woman. None of that should be in your damn vocabulary. Idiot.
But, you know, I'm not a killer, I'm OJ.
All right. Well, this is like our first episode together. I think it went really well. I'm glad I started off season 2 this way, episode 31. I'm gonna name it season 2, episode 31.
Word.
I forgot one of my other important subjects. Comedy. I'm gonna do this super quick, and then we go end this because you know I like it short and sweet. Unless we have a guest or something like that, we can go longer. Kevin Hart is doing well. He is. He's gonna get out of hospital, and then he goes into rehab. So he's getting out of the hospital tomorrow, and then he's going to rehab for 2 weeks. His spirits are high. He's beginning to walk. You know, he got major back injuries from that car accident. I love Kevin Hart. They tried to cancel him during his car accident, but we'll talk about later about this woke culture that we got. Real quick, I don't know if you watched The Shop. You remember when you buy my house, I had you watch The Shop and LeBron sit around and talk to everybody?
Yeah.
Okay, this is my opinion on this super quick, is that not everything is to share with every fucking body, period. Like, some things need to stay where it's at. I've been in barbershops before because I have a lot of male friends. It is what it is. I've been in some crazy ones in Jamaica, Queens, and New York. Fun stuff. Some of that stuff we don't necessarily need to show the world because the world don't understand everything.
Mm-hmm.
And as much as we think social media is so much for us to broadcast ourselves and be transparent and be real and show ourselves, some stuff just ain't for everyone.
And when you think about it, the barbershop for men is like, it's almost all we got, you know?
Right. So, that's how we are with hair salons. When I go get my hair done, we sit down, we got people all kind of different opinions.
Yeah.
Whatever they talk about, there's no judgment. We get in arguments, we get in debates. And then by the end of the time we there, because we spend a lot of time here, we get up and leave and everybody's cool.
Yep. It's like they're
and everybody respects each other. Like, okay, that's how she think. Oh yeah, well you know her. She always going. And same in the barbershop, man. So I appreciate trying to bring the culture out to the mainstream on HBO to see how it goes. But some shit just don't need to be out there. Just some stuff keep to ourselves because they don't understand it. So they tried to call Kevin homophobic because he was on with a Lil Nas X, and Lil Nas X was talking about him coming out, and Kevin was like, "So what? You're gay." That's all. That's what Kevin said. But I understood what Kevin was saying. Like that's not coming out. Is not, nobody cares anymore. And I'm not saying it in a mean way. You should be happy. It's not a big deal anymore.
Yeah.
No one's not like, it's not a big deal anymore. You guys have conquered what you wanted. And then Kevin gets, oh, he's gaslighting. I just love how they'll take one word and now it's used in everything. He's gaslighting. He was gaslighting Lil Nas X. Whatever. Lil Nas X used to be a troll for Nicki Minaj. He used to be a barb. he used to be a troll on the internet. So he's not perfect either. So y'all want to, like, I mean, he did articulate very well and explain, and he handled it well, but it wasn't nothing going on that was wrong. That's how the barbershop is. That's exactly how it is. So just my opinion, some things, people, we don't need to share with the world. I know there's podcasts, there's shows, and our little Brian was trying to do all some things. I like the shop if they keep it to a surface level. Don't try to act like it's really the shop, because it really isn't, though, to be honest. That's really lame compared to what a real barber shop would be like. I mean,
in the hood.
What'd you say?
I said in the hood. Yep.
It's a different thing. So he'll be out. Eddie Murphy said he'll never stop making music. He doesn't want us fans to know because he think it'll scare us. I love Eddie. Paul Mooney has a big scandal going on. I talked about this in my previous episode. Paul Mooney allegedly sexually molested Richard Pryor Jr. Paul Mooney has twins. They came out and said that Richard Pryor Jr. never said who it was, so people need to calm down. But Paul Mooney canceled all his comedy shows, but they claim he's super sick. That's why he did it. And then, so we're going to stop at that. I think this is a good introduction to us. I think it went pretty well. I had a good time with it. I'm glad I have a co-host and somebody to talk to. I appreciate you, bro, for supporting a Black woman.
I appreciate you.
It's Black Girl Magic right now. Black women are in. You need to check out Black Lady Sketch. I think I told you that already, but you need to check that out. I love that show. So we'll be doing this weekly. We in season two. I don't know how I made this season two. Don't ask me my logic or the numbers.
But what is it called? What's the show called?
No reason.
No reason. Ain't got to be no reason.
No reason. There's no reason. I just made this season two. Out of thin air. This is season two. So... Once again, we'll do this once a week. We both are consistent now. The summer's over. So I can't say hot girl summer. My hot woman summer's over with. That's something. This summer was, it was fun. I'm not going to lie. I had me a good time this summer. So how was your summer real quick?
I mean, it was cool. But, you know, Suave Boy Winter is about to get popping. So,
oh,
you know.
Shit, I didn't know that's a damn thing. Well, Suave Boy Winter.
Because you need your Suave lotion in the winter, you know what I'm saying? You'd be ashy. So,
oh, boy, you know, here we go.
You hacked.
So Suave Boy Winter. Okay, yep. Okay. Well, I'm a chill. I'm gonna be mine. I don't know what I'm going to have this winter. I just know my summer. I don't know if I could top it. Can we get to fall, though? What are we going to do with fall? We just going to skip fall?
In Milwaukee, ain't no fall. Winter just hits you when it's on the bricks.
Yeah, you're right. It'll be snowing next week. We'll fall back. We'll just lay back. We can't think of, I can't come up with nothing.
We'll call it fall back autumn.
Nah.
Nah.
Yeah, I don't like that.
I like that.
Oh yeah, you're the marketing guy. Let me be quiet. Fall back autumn. Okay.
Yeah.
What the hell does that mean?
It's fall. It's autumn. Another name for fall. And we falling back. We chilling. It's summer. We taking a break from summertime, so we got to.
Oh yeah, I do. This is the first time in a long time I was so appreciative to see football start, because I was like, this summer has been wild. Let's take it down a notch. And yeah, I was real happy to see football. I was like, damn, normally I don't want to see summer end. I did want to see it end. But man, I'm not going to lie. When it did, I was like, woo, I need a break. That was too much. That was way too much, but it was a good time. All right, so check this out. We'll be back next week. I hope everybody have a great week. Is there anything you want to plug or promote? I think you did that in the beginning, but if you want to give your shout outs again, my lovely co-host.
Nah, I mean,
lovely, I think, pause. Sorry.
Yeah, you gotta get all get all whatever with it, but I think I did enough plugging, but stay tuned next week though. Cause we might have to cover some, you know what? Just come back next week for that. Cause I'm not even going to give you a teaser. Cause I need y'all gotta stay tuned. Season two going to be lit. That's all I got to say.
Yeah. Season two going to be, yeah, we got it together this season. All right. Of course, you know, I'm NolaJComedy.com. That's everything. Please, I need followers. I'm going to have to use my bro here to help me marketing more and get my life together. I'm going to do better for season two. But I appreciate everyone that listens, has been faithful fans. I totally appreciate you guys. You guys have a great week. Once again, my name is Nola J, a.k.a. Chocolate Blonde, a.k.a. Jizzle. And you guys have a great week. Peace out.
Peace.
Deuces.
Tell a friend to download and subscribe to the No Reason Podcast with Nola J, the Chocolate Blonde. Go to the website nolajcomedy.com. That's nolajcomedy.com.